Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. And it is Wednesday and it is a beautiful day. And if you listened to me yesterday to the video, then you already are having a better day than you did yesterday because you ignored all the crap on your Facebook news feed, the tweeters and the Instagrammers and all that crap. Just ignore it. It's okay to get a little dose, you know, just to find out what's going on, but don't get involved. Stay the heck away because all it's going to lead to is piss poor sleep and worry and frustration and all that crap. I have another video to bring you today. Thanks to 757 Dawg Pound said, hey, I want to share my video with everybody. And I freaking love it when people do this. I said this yesterday. I absolutely love it. And I actually got two yesterday, so I'm going to bring you one tomorrow too, probably. If I have time, I have to prepare for the Vendors United Mastermind tomorrow night. But and I'm behind on emails and stuff like that, just like normal. But I am having a blast watching these videos. And another one sent me a slew of photos of their setup, wanted me to critique it. So I'm going to be getting to that as well. But today we've got 757 Dawg Pound, brand spanking new vendor with his big dog cart. That's the big dog right there in the corner. And that's me up here showing it off. I did a walk around tour of it. You can watch that here on the page, or you can go to Hot Dog Cart Store and watch it. Anyway, let's get to this and watch this video, and I'll pause it every now and then if there's something I need to point out or explain. All right, so here we go.
How's everybody doing today? So this is going to be my post. 757 Dawg Pound, we are now officially open. This is my first day out. I just got inspected again. She came out to watch my whole entire setup, to see how it's set up. She asked questions, everything. So I got to get a, she gave me a new sheet. So my schedule yesterday was 98. So I got a 99 now because when I'm transporting my meat in that cooler, I need to have a thermometer in that cooler, and I can transfer that thermometer to this one. So that was the only thing I didn't know about. She didn't ding me on some things. She just made me aware of some things like the onions, my cocoa lines that I cook at home. I'll have, especially if I go, when I go to Lexington, I'll have to cook it on site. So that's why I got the grill. See, I got the menu board up. I actually got to hand people their condiments. So that's why I slid them back. I did have them up here.
Okay, now this is a more than likely a COVID rule right now, is handing them their condiments. And I'm not sure why he can't put the condiments on, but he can't let them grab condiments. He's got to give them condiments. So if they want three ketchup packs right now due to the COVID, he's got to hand it to them.
So I had to hand them their condiments. I got my sales and tax use permit. I've got that. And I got to actually carry my food safe certified with me. I didn't bring it with me. It's actually in my folder at home. So I have to remember that. I'll put that in the car when I go home. So right now what we got is, I got sodas in here. I do have chips. You see I got some actual bratwurst working up here. So down here I got brats in here. I got hot dogs, quarter pounders, and beef sausage in here. Where I put the buns when the customer comes to make an order. It doesn't take long because it's hot. I got peppers and onions.
So what he was showing there is in the one steam table, and we're going to go back to this because he's going to show something else in a minute, but with the buns, he's doing the rapid steam method, and it's where you just have it rapidly boiling water in a low, it's got a false bottom in it. You'll see that in a minute. And he throws them in there. They heat very quickly, so you get this nice, hot, steamy bun almost immediately, so there's no worry about buns getting soggy or dried out or anything. It's a great way to do it.
And I got Coca-Cola onions right there.
So he's got his Coca-Cola onions.
And we go over to the cooler. So I got my buns in here. I didn't put every single bun in here that I have. I just put a few. I got my square reader that I need to plug into my phone. Inside my cooler, I got the four freezer blocks of water, 4 gallons of them that are frozen.
Now, some of you may ask, okay, why has he got blocks of water in there? This is just a way to keep a cooler cool without having to go buy ice. Not that ice is expensive, but it makes a mess. And sometimes the ice will leak into other products and they don't want that at the health department. They'll allow you to use ice, but you have to have a drain and all that. This way, you don't have to worry about anything. Now, is he probably got a little overkill with his ice? He's got 3 full gallons of ice, probably, but better safe than sorry. He's keeping it at temp. That's why he just got a 99 on this inspection today. This was yesterday. So he got a 99, only 1 point off, and that was, he said it at the beginning. I forget it was nothing, it was minimal. So the bottom line is you, eventually you'll want to get ice packs, gel packs, to go in the cooler. They take up less space and they last longer, but most vendors are only out there for a couple hours. So there's really not a need for long-term coolers or long-term ice protection or cold protection, because you're not out there that long. So this, all I would suggest is go with smaller jugs of liquid so that you have more room for your product.
Got hot dogs, quarter pounders, and beef sausage in here. I got coleslaw and I got sauerkraut. And I'm putting beef stock in my water. It's unsalted, because there's already enough salt in the hot dogs. So I bought it unsalted. You add that to the water, give a little beef flavor. So these right here are actually going to go back in. And the reason why I grilled them, because I know some people like theirs grilled. I actually have this grill on medium. Okay? So today is the first day. The opening day.
Now, I will tell you this. He's saying, and I know the audio is a little low, and I've got it jacked up, but he's saying that he grills some of his sausages, his brats, because people like it. Some people like it. Actually, everybody likes it. Nobody had turned down a grilled brat or a grilled hot dog or sausage or whatever. It's always better to grill them. It's just for the eye candy appeal of it, though, because they're already cooked. And so he's sticking them up there and throwing them on and putting the pretty char marks, kind of like I've showed you with Frankenstein's cart set up.
7 Dawg Pound. I've actually turned the temperatures down because this thing is extremely hot. As you see, the sides get so hot that if your product is touching, it actually burns the product.
Now, what he's got right there, let me back that up just a hair, okay? So this is what you can do to create a steam pan when you don't have a perforated pan or you don't have space. That's what's called a false bottom. Okay. So it's just a little wire mesh thing that goes in the bottom. You put a little water in there and it creates steam. Okay. It keeps your product from direct heat as well. So he's already got pre-cooked foods in there. He's talking about the burners getting hot. This is a common issue, with all carts. If they put in good burners, you can have too many burners on. He probably could get away with just having one burner on. Once he got his food cooked and he had boiled everything and got ready to go, he could turn it all off, put one burner on low, and he'd be good to go. He wouldn't have this problem with the scorching the sides of them. But some people, like my wife, if she opened this pan and saw this, she'd be all about that. She likes that burnt sausage, burnt hot dog. She likes charred up. She likes it like that. And a lot of people do.
If your product is touching, it actually burns the product. So I'm probably going to put some more water in here to bring the level up. And I have the water right here, so let's go ahead and pour it in and get that sizzling steam. So
now, normally if you were adding water to a false bottom, you wouldn't go all the way past the screen. In his case, it won't matter. He's not putting buns in there or anything. He's just making sure. But being a new vendor, he's got it set a little too high, so he's cooking a little high. Needs to lower that and just let them kind of simmer in there, and they'll stay plenty hot.
Have it come up to 165, and come to 165, then I can hot hold it. I can hot hold, see, that's what happens with the sidewalls, get so hot. Then I can hot hold at 135. So the beef sausages are here, the regular beef hot dogs are in the middle, and quarter pounds are right here. I actually already had a sale. I've had a sale already. Somebody zooming their motorcycle. I've had a sale already. Some people came by, they had a boat attached to their van. They bought 2 quarter pounders of regular hot dog and got 2 waters. So, you know, good little auspicious start. And I had some people out here earlier. I wasn't ready yet. I told them it was about 30 minutes and they left. So hopefully they'll come back because I'm ready now. I'm fully set up. See, I got my Heimlich thing right there, and right there. And like I said, I got everything on the table. Got some disinfectant wipes. Got my business cards. So, and due to this situation we got, I need to hand them these right here. So right now, everything looks good. I had to dilute this because you can't have straight bleach. It's got to be a mixture. I got my soap, got some vinegar, and I got my gloves. I'm going to put on another pair of gloves when I get the next customer. So you guys have a great day. This is the beginning of the 757 Dawg Pound. And let me see. Yeah, I got Mountain Dew, Pepsi, and waters in here. So, and that's the whole hookup that I need to hook the car.
So I want to point out that right there. He didn't, if you notice, brand new vendor, he followed the rules. He didn't go overboard. I see vendors go out there and try to put 15 different types of drinks. They got 7 coolers, and they try to be too much to too many people. That is a common problem. You want to slim that back. You saw the video I did yesterday of the vendor in Wake County, North Carolina. And he actually messaged and already had changed some stuff. He got more chip clips and hung those up today in the center of his umbrella, so it made it look fuller. But you, I love how 757 Dawg Pound here is doing this. As far as he started with Mountain Dew and Pepsi and water, keep it simple, and you've got something about for anybody.
Pull it back home. So I'm going to be out here probably at about 4 o'clock, seeing what I can do, seeing how this goes. I couldn't put my banner up. I tried, but it sits down on the ground. So I need something to raise this up so I can put the banner on it. Because it actually needs to sit up above the table. Okay, so I'm thinking about getting some magnets. So when I'm set up like this, I can just put it on the side of the car and magnetize it. And the chips are in the car too, in case I get some combo sales. But right now, I'll take those little individual sales. So
now if you noticed, he's got his toe hitch out there with the cover and stuff. I would put that in my trunk for now. I wouldn't have any unnecessary stuff that distracts from the aesthetics, the view, the beauty of the setup I have. I may even move my car a little further away. I saw a vendor that, well, I filmed him in Knoxville, Tennessee, that did he'd leave his van attached to his cart because he was lazy. That's all it comes down to. He was lazy. And it doesn't look as good. It looks like, hey, I'm a fly-by-night vendor. I could pack up and go at any moment. I just got to turn on the keys and head down the road. It doesn't look as professional. You're already a mobile vendor. Stay there with that and try to make your area as clean as possible. About his banners, he's going to put a banner on the side of the car. Great idea. Drives more traffic. A swooper flag would probably help him immensely. I would definitely get a swooper flag immediately. That's what I would do. I'd get a big feather. They call them feather flags or swooper flag. Get one 12, 15 foot tall and put it up, and you won't have to worry about a banner right now. Later, if you want to do a tent, and I'm going to tell you, he sent me another video last night, that 757 did. He sent me another video. He's going to be doing, fried, seafood. So he's allowed to. So he's doing fried seafood. And he's got a 3-burner setup for fried seafood, and then he can transfer that to the cart for holding. And the health department's letting him do that. They're not requiring all that, the air handler and all that stuff, because he's outdoors. And so more than likely he's going to have a pop-up tent, but they already came by and checked out his brand new 3-pot boiler system that he set up for doing frying. It's a pretty cool setup.
It's the beginning. 2 years in the making. A lot of people thought it wouldn't happen, but it has. Thank you for those of you who supported me, believed in my dream, pushed me, and said it could be done. You know, I want to thank Allah, because this is the last day of Ramadan. Last day of Ramadan, first day of freedom. I guess that's what they say, huh? And I'd like to thank my grandmother, too, because both of them have taught me patience. So when I wanted this, it wasn't time for it to happen. You know, everything comes in time. Everything comes in time. Y'all have a great day. And like I said, welcome to the 757 Dawg Pound. And this is how we're doing it.
I'll pause it right there so you can see his menu a little bit. What you can tell, he's got a calmness about him. Brand new. This is his first day. And he's very thorough. He's read and watched everything. He's done his due diligence. The only thing lacking here is signs. But before he could even completely get set up, he already had customers, and then, which he just mentioned, and then he had a customer as soon as he got set up, the people with the boat, so who got some combo meals. The cart that needed a sink, Bill, was yesterday, and it didn't really need one. That was in North Carolina, and North Carolina doesn't require sinks. You're always better to have sinks, okay? It looks better. And it allows you to wash your hands, which looks really good in front of customers. Tennessee doesn't require sinks. So there are states that don't require it. And so some vendors don't have it. It's why we make a cash cow cart with no sinks. So because of those states that don't require it. Okay, so that was it. I think this was a fantastic video. And the way he calmly went through everything and showed everything. So the two things I'd point out, signage needs it bad. And two, even if it's homemade signs, his menu looks fantastic. The other thing I would point out is burners are way too hot. And I've made that mistake when I started, and about every vendor does. We crank everything up. You know, the big dog has three high powered burners. And so you turn them up and you get your stuff boiling and you're like, oh my gosh, things are burning and sticking to the sides. And, you know, it's a nightmare. I used to complain about the chili in my course book, Hot Dog Saved My Life. I complain about chili burning and the nightmare of cleaning those pans at night. And then I figured out, oh, I could have prevented that by turning down burners or putting in pan savers or doing the double broiler system. We've got so many cool tips and tricks in Vendors United. I hope that if you have any inclination to get into the business or want to get started and you want to be surrounded by people like that are in here right now, like Stever, that's in here, you get to be surrounded by professionals, people that are constantly learning, listening, coming up with their own ideas and sharing those ideas as they test them out. That's the kind of people you'll be with in Vendors United. It's vendorsunited.com. Somebody messaged me yesterday after I did the YouTube live. They said, Ben, I looked up Vendors United on Better Business Bureau, and it has a 1-star and an F rating and a blah, blah, blah. And I said, what? And so I go look it up, and it's some company. There was some company. They ain't in business. They were in business years ago and had nothing to do with hot dog vending, street food vending, or catering, or any of that stuff. And it was some kind of company that existed called Vendors United. I have no idea, but they do have a bad rating. Don't join that one. You want to join vendorsunited.com or vendorsunited.org. Either one will get you to us, and you can try it out. And I want to say hi to everybody that's here. James Max in the house. Casey's in the house. Stever, I already mentioned. The Bill is in the house. Cornell Harris. Jason Norwood from Texas is in the house. Blake is in the house. Thanks for being here. I appreciate it. It helps me move along too, and I can answer questions better. So Scott says, good money and hot dogs? Nope, it sucks. I'm just kidding. Yeah, of course there is. Now, are there people that go out and struggle a little bit? Yep. Are there people, though, that learn and do it right from the get-go? Yes. There's people like Squatch Dogs who stayed in VU for a year before he even opened his cart, came out like a pro when he started, and started making huge money immediately. So, yes, definitely there's, if people are eating, you can be selling hot dogs. So I guess that's it. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will be back probably tomorrow. I'm going to try to come back tomorrow with the other video I got yesterday. And if you have a video you want to send in and let me talk about it, or let me critique it, or you want to do a walk around tour, or you want to explain your business or how you got started, send it to me. You can send me emails at ben@vendorsunited.com. I have, the video tomorrow. This is so cool. It's commissary, that he made in his own home. It's brilliant, and it's certified as a commercial kitchen. And then, I'll give you a teaser, how he does 500 dozen cookies, bakes at home, and sales in a 10-day period. Okay. So we're going to do that tomorrow, and I'm going to give you a tour of his whole commissary that he built right inside his house. It's freaking awesome. So, I'll get on to that. Looking into getting as educated as possible to take over Dad's Hot Dog Cart. He passed 5 years ago, and it's time to take his cart down south and out of storage. I've always wanted to. I'll tune in daily. Unknown. Sorry about your dad. I hate that, and it hurts my heart for anybody to lose anybody, but we all do. But I think it's awesome that you're taking his passion and his thing and doing it. You'll love this business. If you like money, you like working, you like picking your own hours, you're not lazy, you're going to love this business. I don't know of anything you can do to make more money per hour, especially like me with no education. But I've got family that are doctors. I've got a brother that's a doctor, and vendors make more than him. Great point, Stever. Thanks for answering that. Awesome. Thomas in the house. I just learned a few pointers about putting out condiments in those pans. See, every time we do something, we learn new stuff, and I love it. I learn new stuff all the time. Wait till you see tomorrow's video. I learn stuff. We're going to have fun. GMA, you know what? I didn't ask him permission to tell where he was. You probably could just Google 757 Dawg Pound and find out where he is, because he didn't mind me using the video or his name. So just check that out and go from there. I'll try to ask him if I can remember to ask him. Look at there. Kimberly's in the house with Teeny Weeny Shack. And he must sell $1 million at $2 each. $2 each. We have some vendors, depending on where you are, $2 is a good price. Some vendors have moved on to $3 now for a regular dog, and then $4 for a quarter pounder. But $2, honestly, if you're buying in bulk, which most vendors are, and I don't mean semi tractor trailer loads, just buying by the case, you're probably paying, if you're buying a quality dog, you might be paying 20 cent a dog. Okay. I know some vendors have worked out deals and they're buying by the pallet, and they're getting their dogs for about 9 to 11 cents on an all beef dog. So some people don't sell all beef dogs. Like in my area, you could sell, even y'all know, Frankenstein's Alex, he sells a all beef and he sells a regular dog. I call it the chicken pecker and beak dog. And that dog sells better. And my wife, my kids, they love the chicken pecker and beak dogs. They want the, you know, the mincemeat dogs, the ones that are pork and beef or pork, beak and chicken or whatever. And they're cheaper. You can get those down. I mean, if you're buying in bulk, like by the pallet, but by the case, you can probably get them for 11 cent. So anyway, Ben, what can I do? Ohio wants me to have a refrigerated unit. Good question. We sell carts with refrigerators built into them. And yes, Ohio is a neat state because you can do so much in Ohio. Ohio, once you get through the little bit of red tape, and you get the cart they want you to get as far as the features they want on it, you can do so much. We got vendors doing pancakes, tamales, street corn, Mexican foods, wraps, gyros, or heroes, or gyro, I don't know. We have vendors doing all kinds of stuff in Ohio. My good friend Keith is in Ohio, and he's doing donuts. He's doing all kinds of fried foods. You can get away with so much in Ohio. It's a great state to vend. So get you a fridge. Find out if you can just take an apartment fridge and mount it to the tongue of your cart, or can you have it there on site with you? They make AC/DC, not the band or the music, but AC/DC fridges. They make an AC/DC gas fridge. They don't recover as quickly. Like when you open the door, they don't like cool back up to the right temp immediately, but they're still doable. So just ask your inspector what they're going to need. It's not uncommon. It won't be too hard. Alexander Marshall says his dogs cost 70 cents each. Yes, some dogs, Alexander's probably, and he can correct me if I'm wrong, he's probably buying a hot dog that is all beef and a quarter pound, okay? And it's probably some name brand. So he's probably paying more. You can work with your local, they call them broadline distributors, And without going through a national broadline like Cisco or IJ, you can probably work with a local broadline in a city near you or in your city. And they are smaller restaurant providers. And they will give you a better price. And they will work out deals for you with a manufacturer. So I know that Vienna hot dogs, they're expensive. They're about 70 cents each. That gets on up there, and that's where you need to be doing $4 and $5 for dogs at that point. Look at there. James Mack says, my dogs are all beef. And I know James is not telling a fib at all, because I have family, I have friends, and I have tons of vendors in VU that are doing the same. About 96 dogs for $20, all beef. So, yeah, Alexander, see, that's a premium Kogels. I've heard of them, a premium dog. And there's nothing wrong with that. Sometimes you have to, but if your market can bear it, then that's what you price according to your market. You don't price according to what you think you want. You price according to your market. We've got vendors that are literally getting on a quarter pound dog $9 because their market can bear it. Their market is the wealthier people. So, let's see. I love it. All right. In North Carolina, has your requirements changed due to COVID-19? Yeah. In North Carolina, the requirements have been, they're pretty simple in North Carolina still. We've got a lot of vendors kicking butt. They were able to vend all through COVID. My buddy Donnie Hill, he's vending in front of an Aldi's and killing it, double and triple what he normally did daily, all because of COVID. Most vendors are killing it when it comes to vending. I talked to one this morning who's in our VU group, and he struggled in March, and then April it opened up. He found he was mostly at industrial parks that closed down. Then he moved over to it's a parking lot, but it's across from a business. Then that business refers him a lot of business, and he does well. And he started feeding the staff of the business free, and because they've been so helpful. It ain't like a tit for tat deal. It's a deal where he just does it on a whim. He goes, hey, I'm going to feed y'all today, or I'll feed y'all tomorrow. And they just keep sending him people, and he's kicking butt. He messaged me just in the last 2 days. I think it was a little over $900, and it's just he and his wife, and they have a rule. They stay out there till they make at least $300. And, the last 2 days have been, over 400. So, I know I'm going to get comments on, oh, you talk too much. You went too long, blah, blah, blah. Don't sell out, bring more, Stever says. Stever and Amy are in Minnesota. These are people that laugh when we say it's cold, and who laugh when somebody says it's too cold and breezy to vend, and they go vend. They shovel snow and they undig their they got a Stand King, and they're working on a brand new trailer they got. They go out in it. You got to love it. Anyway, oh, there you go, Stever. Looky there. Here's the price. Quarter pound dog, $14. See? Depends on your area. This is the kind of stuff, and you may be going, okay, I got to find out more about the Stever guy and what he's doing. Join Vendors United. Talk to Stever. Him and his wife are in there. And every day they post. Every day people post and comment and help each other. It is the best place to go to get good information fast. So it's great. Hey, Space Coast hot dogs in the house. Don't worry about being late. This is recorded, so you can be as late as you want. Okay, so you can tell them in the laundry room. Did y'all hear the washing machine get off balance just now? Anyway, I love you. I got to go. I'll talk to you soon. And tomorrow, bringing you another video. Got to show you this video. This guy's commissary is awesome.